Now we will study about agrarian relations. In Mughal period, the political stability contributed to the growth of agriculture, trade and commerce. Trade and commerce means activities related to buying and selling of goods. So as agriculture was the main income of the revenue, it continued to dominate the economy. Dominate means to control. It was the principal produce among the food grains. Some food grains, spices and condiments were exported from the Gujarat, Bengal and Deccan. But do you know there was no any import? So only that no foodstuff were import, but only fruits were imported at that time. And other delicacies. Delicacies means that items with the quality of being easily damaged. Only that delicacy items were imported at that time. The peasant had to pay nearly half of his produce as a tax, but they had enough to eat and to meet their simple requirements. In this period, a peasant was not dispossessed from his land as long as he paid the land revenue. Dispossessed means deprived. Okay, so they were not dispossessed and they were not deprived of their land as they were paying the land revenue. They could sell his land, and if they did not do so, then his children inherited it after his death. Inheritation means to receive the property. Means after the death of that particular person, his children, they will be the having that piece of land. And with the help of that land, they will earn for their livelihood. Now, there were two types of peasants. First, peasants who owned the land, they tilted, they were called khudkasht. And they were paid land revenue at customary rates. Customary rate means according to the custom. These peasants told the land, they are having the land, plough and bullocks. Everything they were having with them. Another kind of peasants were those who didn't have their own land, plough, bullocks, often till the land of zamindar, and they could manage to eke out an existence. Eke out an existence means to manage to live with very little money or food. Now these kinds of peasants were called pais. There was an abundance. Abundance means a very large quantity. So there was abundance of cultivable land available during this period. Peasants proprietors. Peasant proprietors means owner of that peasants. They were more in number, and the pais and the village artisans were less. There was a vast difference between the luxurious lifestyle of the nobles and the zamindars. This was the first group that was including zamindars and the nobles. Another group was the terrible poverty of peasants, artisans and laborers who were under the heavy burden of taxation was coming. The right to ownership of the land was dependent mainly on the succession. Succession means the condition under which one person after the another succeeds the property. The new right of ownership of land were being created all the time, means purchase of land could be done, and the person who first brought land under the cultivation, that was considered its owner. Zamindar had the hereditary right of collecting revenue from a number of villages, and this was called his taluk or zamindari. When the zamindar collected the land revenue, they had right to keep up to 25% of the revenue as his share. But they were not the owner of the land. But in modern zamindars, they are having their own land. The peasants who actually cultivated the land could not be dispossessed of their land unless they stop paying the rent revenue. The two groups of the zamindars and the peasants both had their own hereditary rights in land. The zamindar were the rajas who dominated large chunks means part of the territories and enjoyed the internal autonomy. Internal autonomy means the right of a person. Now, in the Mughal period, at the time of Akbar, the society was in a hierarchical or stratified. Hierarchical and stratified means in a system that is organized in some layers or some order. Zamindar had their own armed forces and they lived in the forts or ghari. The zamindar were in a great amount about. They all were separated and they all are working in different direction. So it was difficult to gather them at one place at one time. Abdul Fazar, I think you all have remembered, the author of Akbarnama, also written Aine Akbari. In this he had written about the number of zamindars, sawars, foot soldiers, elephants and cannons. Cannons means large gun on a ship or army vehicle. So Abul Fazal have recorded in this, he have recorded about the number of all these things. First zamindars, all the items of zamindars. First as sawar, they were 384,558. Foot soldiers were 42,77,057. Elephants were 1,863 and cannons were 4,260. Now in this manner, zamindar formed a very large number of powerful, or he had created a number of items and it was the most powerful class. This was the main reason that the king or any central authority could not ignore them. Now apart from zamindars, there were a large class of religious divines. Religious divines means related to God. They were scholars who were granted tracts of land. Tract means area. Area of land for their maintenance. Such grants were called Madad-e Maash, help. Okay. These grants very often became hereditary. It also became hereditary. Means it also depends upon the succession. Passing from one person to another. Now many of the grantees were writers, scholars, artists, etc. For instance, Akbar granted a piece of land to Sikh Guru Ram Das, which later on developed into a town. In present it is called Amritsar. This much for today's class, and we have finished this chapter. Very soon you will get the notes of this chapter, and the notes that you have got, keep on writing and keep on learning. In the next class, we will be starting the new chapter of geography. Okay. And that will be the fifth chapter of geography, that is water on land. Please do reading of that chapter so you can easily understand the explanation. Thank you for the class.